This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And this video is going to be a very basic introduction to matrices. So we can think of a matrix as a way of arranging information in rows and columns. So for instance, if I take this table that I have here with all the information in it, the table represents the colors of marbles, red, yellow, blue, and green, that we find in three different boxes, box one, box two, and box three. So for instance, box one contains 5 red marbles, 6 yellow marbles, 1 blue marble, 3 green marbles. And we have the same kind of information for the other two boxes. If we wanted to make a matrix out of this, we could call this, let's say, matrix A. We usually use capital letters to designate a matrix. And now I'm just going to take the information and make some rows and columns. So for box one, I had 5, and then 6, and 1, and 3. For box two, I had 4, 7, 3, and 8. And for box three, I had 8, 2, 10, and 9. We usually put square brackets around a matrix. And now what I've got is a matrix representation of the information that was in that original table. Okay? Here's another example of that. Let's say I've got a system of equations. I've got 2x plus 5y equals 12, and 3x minus 4y equals 15. And I just want to represent the numerical parts of these two equations. So I'm going to make matrix B, and matrix B is going to have as its first row a 2, a 5, and a 12, and the second row will be a 3, a negative 4, and a 15. And that would be a representation. Matrix B is a representation of the information that I had in those two equations. Okay, let's talk about terminology. So here are two more matrices. Matrix C has 2 rows and 4 columns. We talk about the size of a matrix by talking about the number of rows and the number of columns. So matrix C is a 2x4 matrix. We always start with the number of rows and then columns. If we have the same number of rows and columns, then we have a square matrix. So matrix D is a square matrix. It's got 3 rows and 3 columns. So matrix D is 3x3. Okay, let's take a look at matrix E. So matrix E is a square matrix. It's 3x3. I can say that there are matrices within this matrix. I can say that there's a row matrix. If I took the first row, 5, 8, and 16, I could call that a row matrix. I would just make a matrix out of that information. It would be a 1x3 matrix. I could do the same thing for the second row and the third row. I could also talk about the column matrices within this. So I could take, let's say, the second column, and I could make a matrix out of that. That would be 8, 9, and negative 4. So that would be a 3x1 column matrix. When we have a square matrix, we can talk about its diagonal. The diagonal is the elements that we get, the parts of the matrix, when we go from the upper right corner of the matrix down to the lower left, the upper left corner of the matrix down to the lower right corner. So the diagonal for this matrix is 5, 9, and negative 2. And we can also talk about the individual parts of the matrix. Each of the numbers in the matrix, each of these numbers is called an element. So if I wanted to talk about, let's say, this number 12, I could describe that by its position. I would use a small version of the name of the matrix. So the name of the matrix is capital E. I'm just going to talk about E, the lowercase, and then as a subscript, the number of the row, it's in row number 2, and a comma, and the number of the column, it's in column 3. So I could talk about element E of 2 comma 3. Sometimes you'll see this 2 comma 3 in parentheses. And I could say that that E of 2 comma 3 equals 12. If I wanted to talk about, instead of that 12, let's say this 3, then that would be E of, or in the third row, first column, E of 3 comma 1. And that would equal 3. Okay? So that's the basic terminology you're going to use with matrices. Take care. I'll see you next time.